Hiya, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about my rods for commercial fishing today. The first rods I'm going to talk about is feeder rods, and my first go-to rod for 90% of my commercial feeder fishing is a 10-foot Mini Plus Carp. Now, the thing is with this rod, okay, it does everything that I want it to do because we're using a lot of inline feeders when we go commercial fishing. Generally, when we fish on commercials, we don't use long hook lengths with big feeders casting out like we did on traditional still waters. What we tend to do is things like method feeders, banjo feeders, or pellet feeders, and they're quite heavy and they cast really nicely. So I always, my first choice when always thinking about a rod is, can I cast to where I want to cast? And with a 10-foot Mini Plus, I can cast comfortably up to 40 meters with inline feeders. So my next consideration has to be, what sort of fish am I catching? If I'm catching 2 to say 15 pound fish, often carp, they're very aggressive and they lunge about a lot, this rod's very forgiving all the way through. Because it's forgiving all the way through and it's quite short, I've got a lot of control over the fish when it comes to netting it. I find that because I've got a short rod, fish can come up a bit closer. When you've got a longer rod, sometimes it can be a bit awkward to net your fish. But when you're fishing with a short rod, you seem to have quite a lot of control. And the other thing is, it's got a through action all the way through the rod. And because of that, any big lunges with barbless hooks, if you're putting the pressure on and the action's all the way through the rod, it can cushion those lunges and the fish don't come off. With stiffer, heavier rods or even a longer rod, sometimes you find that that late lunge bounces the fish off. So at any possibility, I try to get away with a 10-foot rod. So with that in mind, sometimes when you go on a commercial, you might want to chuck further. So maybe lakes such as Preston, for example, or anywhere where you're chucking Larford Match Lake, anywhere like that, where you may be casting quite a long way, you might want to consider a more powerful rod. That's when I look at the 11-6. Okay, this is a power carp rod. And what that does is it means you can cast that little bit further. You lose a little bit of the forgiveness that you had on the 10-foot rod, but it's worth it to be able to cast where the fish are. So when I'm looking at casting, say, 40 to 80 meters, I can cast comfortably there with this rod. As long as I've got a big enough feeder to cast, compress the rod fully, this rod gets me there. And that's my two feeder fishing rods for commercials. I don't complicate it with other types of rod. Those two do everything. The 10-foot Mini Plus is brilliant because actually, even if I'm bream fishing or it's hard, I can use that to catch a bit of everything. The next thing I want to look at is waggler rods. So with the same principle really as the feeder rods, I have two types of waggler rods I use. The first one is the 11-foot two-piece. Now, the 11-foot two-piece Mini Plus, the beauty with that is that it's got a nice through action all the way through and it's very soft. I know traditionally we like to use, like, say, 13-foot rods. And when I'm waggler fishing, I do like a little bit of a longer rod to pick up all the line and strike into my fish. But what you find with a lot of commercials is the pegging can be quite tight. You're not, you know, there's trees around you. You can't really have a lot of room for your rods. Or you might not be casting a long way. You might be casting, say, 15, 20 meters. So what I tend to do is I use the 11-foot because it's a little bit shorter, gives me more control, and I can still pick up. And the thing is, based on what I was saying about the 10-foot rod, I've got the same thing with this. I've got a through action. So all those big lunges at the net when I'm playing the fish, they're there, and the rod cushions the lunge, and I can net the fish cleanly. That's really important to me. More fish in the net means I'm going to win more matches. Of course, there is situations where I might want to cast a bigger waggler, a heavier waggler, and I might want to cast a bit further, and all the carp I'm hooking are a bit bigger. Venues such as viaduct, you might want to cast a bit further, and the fish are big, you know, you might want a stronger rod or a heavier waggler. And if you do want that sort of thing, I look at the 12-foot power float. Okay, the 12-foot power float is the rod that I've used for a long time. It's got that little bit of extra length, it's got a plenty of strength in it, and I can cast it that bit further. So when I'm looking for that little bit more, again, I wouldn't use this week in, week out. It's a bit harsher. And if the carp are, say, 2 pound and I'm only casting 20 meters, I run the risk of bumping an odd one off. So that's when I keep to the 11-foot. So really dead simple. Same principles for both rods, feeder or float. Look at the shorter rods for control and forgiveness when you're playing a fish. and look for the longer, heavier rods, okay, when you're looking for a little bit extra distance. Hope that's helped.